Wild have won just three of their last nine games, but it's not for a lack of production from Zach Parise, who has points in 10 of his last 13 with 8 goals and 5 assists over that span. Tonight they take on the Sharks at home in Minnesota. For more on that, we say hello to Mike Russo. Mike, yesterday Bruce Boudreau announced that Matt Dumba will miss some time with an upper body injury. What's the latest, and how will his absence impact the Wild?
Well, it's going to be really impactful, but I will say that Bruce today ended all chances of the Wild using this as an excuse, pointing out that it's the only injury the Wild have, and other teams are just absolutely decimated by injury. But Matt's been unbelievable this year, and we talked about it on the last show. He leads the league with 12 goals. It's his fourth straight year with 10-plus goals or more, and he's been the guy that has made their power play as dominant as it is. He's almost unstoppable from that left circle. So the question is how long he's out right now. The Wild are being really mum about that. It sounds like it did happen in the fight with Matt Tkachuk 40 seconds into the game the other night. We don't know what it is other than it's an upper body injury, but just listening to people in the locker room, that nobody seems to be expecting him back anytime soon.
All right, so they lose Dumba, but they do get Mikko Koivu back in the lineup. What are the lines going to look like tonight?
Yeah, Mikko comes back. He's the one that was kneed by Mark Giordano in Calgary last week, and that kind of set off this whole thing that happened in the last in the rematch the other day. But the lines here are going to be totally different. Mikko Koivu, for as long as I've been covering this team, has been the first or second line center. Tonight he'll be the third line center. What Bruce will do is try to get more balance up and down the lineup from lines one through three. He's keeping rookie Jordan Greenway with Eric Staal and Mikael Granlund. He wants to keep the Zach Parise, Charlie Coyle, and Nino Niederreiter line together. They've been really good the last couple games, and Coyle's really played well with that move to center. So tonight, Jason Zucker, who missed the last game with food poisoning, will come back, play on a line with rookie Luke Cunningham and veteran Mikko Koivu, and Bruce hopes that it will become a team that suddenly is much harder to check because they have scorers on every single line.
All right, well, we'll see how those lines work out tonight. One thing that the Wild have had just a little bit of trouble with as of late, Mike, is the third period. What's going on there?
Yeah, it's an issue. Last game's just been a kind of a trend lately. 1-1 third period, you're at home, you are playing a great team. You got to win that game, though, and the Wild now, seven times this season, they've been in a third period where they've either had the lead or tied at one point and they didn't wind up winning the game. The Wild haven't been to an overtime since October 20th, so they're not even forcing these games to get the potential overtime loss point. And it's amounted to 11 regulation losses since October 20th, and a team that's gone from second in the conference to ninth. So they've got to start winning these games in the third. Devan Dubnyk's got to be better in the third period. I don't blame him the other night, but the reality is out of the 48 goalies that have faced 100 shots or more in the third period, he ranks 44th in save percentage. 887 in the third period needs to be better.
Certainly does. Allow me to use a overused hockey cliche. You got to play a full 60, right, Mike?
Exactly, Jackie.
Mikael Granlund, Zach Parise leading this team with a combined 62 points on the year. Before we let you go, what's impressed you the most about the way those two have played this season?
Well, what's been unbelievable is they've been pretty much on separate lines all season long, and Zach Parise has just, to me, it's one of the feel-good stories of the league. He's been a hot goal scorer since March 1st of last year, 15 goals. Remember, he missed the first half of last season after having back surgery, but he's gotten himself back to being the hard-working, gritty guy that scores all his goals from the blue paint. He's been awesome, and Mikael Granlund, he's one of the most underrated playmakers in the league. Wherein this guy is their linchpin offensively, the Wild score a ton of goals. He's at more than a point per game. The other night against Calgary, the Wild played a team that has five players with a point a game, averaging more than 1 point per game. Mikael Granlund's on pace for 84 points this year. That would be the franchise record, and he's their only guy with more than a point a game. He's been awesome this year.
Yeah, and really awesome to see Parise doing so well after being so injury-plagued last season and having a little bit of trouble there. Thanks for this, Mike. Enjoy the game tonight.